अज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महाबदन्याय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्य गौरद्विषे नमः। गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकायै तदाने कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तदभक्ताय नमो भक्त्या विहीना अपराध लक्ष्यै क्षिप्ताश्च कामादितरङ्ग मध्ये कृपामयीं त्वं शरणं प्रपन्न वृन्दे नमस्ते चरणारविन्दम्। तवैवास्मि न जीवामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाय राधे त्वं नय माम चरणान्ति। हम लोग पढ़ रहे थे रूप गोस्वामी गिविंग हिज मर्सी टू श्रील रूप गोस्वामी महाप्रभु इज गिविंग हिज मर्सी टू श्रील रूप गोस्वामी एंड ही टोल्ड अबाउट द भक्ति कृपा फ्रॉम बिगिनिंग टू एंड। दिस इज द परम फल परम पुरुषार्थ फॉर ए डिवोटी और दिस इज द हाइएस्ट aim, object and everything. There is nothing or beyond this. If a man has even a little taste, not even taste, he has nishtha even, then his life will be changed. What is the fruit of association, high class of association? And if you are beginning this bhakti, in beginning, I told you that it will be kleshakni and subhada, and all worldly desire will go. So you can judge yourself, keeping your hands here, that hearing so much, our desires have lessened or gone or not. Still desire to test all these things, sense gratifications and all these things. Now, a wish is coming or not to be like that. Three things I repeated so many times. Bhakti, Pareshanubhava, Virakti. Three at a time. And if you are hearing all these things, also practicing chanting Harinam, also hearing so much. But no detachment from worldly things, desire. What is this? What is this? You have no care. You don't like this. So many desires are there. So, bhakti is not doing anything. Why? Why bhakti is not doing? Very powerful, like Krishna himself. But he cannot, she cannot do anything. So try to follow this. If there is bhakti, oh, detachment is there, surely. And some taste is there, and some satisfaction is there, and Atma always happy. So there is something loophole. You'll have to discover that thing and to give up all these things gradually. So this is called nishtha. By intelligence knowing for future. It may be sometimes some defects, but this nishtha is there. Any problem may come, but I will increase my faith, doing bhakti, nam, chanting and all these things. Gradually giving up all the worldly desires, giving up. This is nishtha. So we should begin from this. Hearing. Don't try to increase your worldly affairs. If you are doing, then you are not following. So gradually go on. I'm not telling that, you should give up your family life. I'm not telling. But try to be like that. Like the associates of Mahaprabhu, associates of Krishna. You should be like that. So he is telling, Eita Parampal, Charam Purushart, Jar Age Trinatulya Chari Purushart. Trinatulya means dry
straws.
Devil rays. Realize all this. Shuddha bhakti haite prema utpan. Only shuddha bhakti, pure bhakti can
give
prema. Other bhaktis that we have nowadays, what? Arup siddha and
sangha siddha.
Karma mishra bhakti, jnana mishra bhakti, yoga mishra bhakti. Having so much desires, worldly desires, and doing bhakti for so much affluence, for so much wealth, beautiful wife, beautiful child, beautiful all these things. This prem cannot come. You'll have to give up forever all these things. And then you can think of this, otherwise not. Ate Suddha Bhakti, Kahe Lakshan. I'm telling you what is Suddha Bhakti. And that is Anya Abhilashita Sunyam, Gyan Karma Dhyana Vritam Anukulena Krishna Anusilanam Bhakti Rutam. You should always remember this slok in your Kanthahar, making
necklace
of the four precious. There is no precious of any chain necklace in this world, necklace in this world. In three words. You should try to remember this as well. And always following. I have discussed so many things, but yet you should translate. Again you should remember.
Mahaprabhuji ne ye slok swayam bola tha.
Mahaprabhu has told himself, but in words, and composed by Rupa Goswami. The inspiration was from Mahaprabhu. In these words and like a poetry, Rupa Goswami did.
We find in the scriptures many definitions of Shuddha Bhakti, transcendental devotional service. But in the writing of Srila Rupa Goswami Pad, we find the most astonishing, most comprehensive, and eloquent, perfect definition ever written. So he has written this, as Srila Gurudev mentioned, on the inspiration of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Anya bilashita shunyam jnana kamad dhanabritam anukulyena krishna anushiram bhakti uttama. The continuous, unbroken cultivation of all endeavors of the body, of the mind, and of the words, and also of spiritual sentiments, which are meant exclusively for the pleasure of Krishna, which are favorable to Krishna, which are not covered by karma, reward-seeking activities, not covered by jnana, the cultivation of knowledge with the intention of achieving impersonal liberation, and not covered by yoga, tapasya, tyag, and types of renunciation which are not related to devotional service. And those endeavors being completely devoid of all other desires except for the desire to please Krishna, they are called Uttama Bhakti, transcendental devotional service. In a very simple way, we may say that just as honey flows from a jar in an unbroken stream, when all of the activities of body, mind, and words and sentiments of the heart are flowing in an unbroken stream continuously towards the lotus feet of Krishna for his service, and when those activities, they're not covered by karma, jnana, yoga, and material desires, then this is called Uttama Bhakti.
Now you should keep your hands on your heart and judge yourself, not to me, that actually this, what you are doing, it is Uttama Bhakti or not. Even second class of bhakti are not. Even third class of bhakti is not. You should judge. If okay, good, very good. And if there is defect, you should try to
repair.
Repair, to reform, to do more. But this is the way, there is no way. And for this, Rupa Goswami has told from beginning, O first Guru Padasya, Sadhu Sangha, then Guru Padasya, in 64 kinds of bhakti.
Limbs of pure bhakti. 64 kinds of limbs.
First Sadhu Sangha. And by Sadhu Sangha?
Guru Padasya.
Oh, a desire may come to serve Krishna. And then he will search where I should buy that seed. And by the help of his Shravan Guru, first Shravan Guru. Shravan Guru means to whom, from whom he is hearing. He will know, oh, who is the best devotee that he can help me. And he knowing my heart and also his heart, Guru heart, or similar type. He is so much advanced, liberated, and myself in this world. But, oh, I have something. So he should be kind to devotee, Guru. And then I will have to surrender and then to follow. Then initiation will come. There was a devotee, he wanted to have initiation from any bona fide guru. And he went. Guru looked his face and read his everything, knew his heart. And told that tomorrow you should come after taking bath to me and I will initiate you. On next day, in very morning, he went to Ganges and took bath, he came. In the meantime, he managed, Gurudev managed a good sweeper that, oh, you should take something.
Dirt.
Dust, not impure. Some
like
pure
dry
dust
leaves.
And thama. 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 So then he took some dry leaves and some dust. Oh, you should not throw it on his head or anywhere, or some far away, that some dust may come and touch. But be very careful. He can run and he can give you
slash.
So you will be very careful and you should run away. Then he came, the devotee. And the sweeper was ready. And when he was coming to take initiation, I am now pure. I have taken bath and putting tilak, everything. He came to Gurudev, was coming. In the way, that sweeper threw out his basket. And some dust touched him. And he became angry. And he took a danda. But anyhow, he controlled. But he was running. He wanted to run away and to
beat.
But see, was out of his touch and he ran away. Then he came to Gurudev. Gurudev, I'm going to take again bath. And then coming, please give me initiation. He told that, you should wait 1 year. 1 year more. You should check your anger. So at the time of initiation, Guru tells that you should keep your this
finger out.
Out of your bag. Why? This denotes anger. I will shoot you. I will punish you. I will break your legs. Who am I? Like this. So anger is so. Enemy. Our enemy. So we should try to realize this. He went. And next year, again he came and he took bath in Ganges and he came to him. He was coming. This time he told sand sweeper that you should take leaves and dust in your basket. And when he will come, you should throw it some more nearer, that some lips should touch his body. But be careful. He may attack you. Then he was coming after taking bath. And then, the sweeper was nearer. And he threw out the basket. And some lips and some dust really touched his body. And he became very furious. But not that. He took not.
No danda, no stick.
And he was taking, very red eyes. You are the problem. Wall between me and my Guru Self, Gurudev, this relation. Again, you did so. So again he took bath and again he was come. Gurudev told that, more 1 year you should wait and after that you should come. Third year, he took bath in Ganges and he was coming. And he told the sweeper, same sweeper, when he will come, you should throw out that basket on the head of that person. But be careful.
He may become angry.
There is no poison, but hordes will come. Understand?
Yes.
To be careful. So, when he was coming, and he threw out his whole basket on the head of that devotee. Now, not so angry, but like so.
Little angry.
And he thought something. And he fell flat on the lotus feet of that
sweeper.
Told that you are refreshing me. You are
refining
me. Now I realize, this is the management of my Gurudev, I am thinking. So he made all these things by trick to reform me. So now you are first my Guru, and then I will go to Gurudev. And he was returned to take again bath, but Gurudev told, you should come, I will initiate you. You are not impure now. Even you will take 100 times of bath, tilak and all other things. But if you have not
removed
your lust,
anger,
worldly desires, or lacks and lacks time, bathing will do nothing. You know, fishes living in
water
always. But if they will touch you, what will be?
Impure.
Oh, some bad smell will come in you. You will be
impure.
So not this will do. Try to remove all the lusts. Oh, I'm married. Oh, I'm not satisfied. Oh, I should change this lady. This lady is not so helpful. Oh, next. Oh, so many, 10 times, 20 times like that. And ladies also like that. This lust, anger, so many worldly desires. Oh, this is not pure. You have to try to give up all this. Then bhakti will come. Bhakti will know. I am seeing and knowing that, he is so much this kind of person, having so much desires, lust. I can see. Swamiji used to see. But even he wanted to help them. But Bhakti Devi, more than anyone, more than Krishna, because Krishna has
invested.
He has invested his all power in Bhakti to look after. And then she will decide where I should go in his heart or not. You cannot deceive Bhakti Devi. You cannot cheat Bhakti Devi. Never you cannot cheat. You cannot cheat her. So, be like that. So, Rupa Goswami is telling, Anya Bancha. Only there will be one desire, how to serve Radha Krishna Kanjugal. And his associates. Anya Bancha. Any kind of desire which is not related to make please Krishna, you should give up. Any devotee is going to take bath. And he has gone to bathroom. I may ask that, why you are taking bath? Why you take bath? Oh, cold air coming?
Yes.
Some why
winds,
cold?
Winds coming.
No. Why you take bath?
Clean from dirty.
Oh, this is karma. Why you talk bath? Very soon. What is really fact? What is the really fact you should tell? Don't tell anything. Don't make late. You can tell I don't know. Or you should know, you should tell. Why you?
So we can be pure in serving Radha Krishna and Gurudev.
We should take bath for Krishna.
Yeah.
How? Oh, if I have gone to bathroom and I have taken bath, then I will be fresh. I will serve Krishna. I will chant Krishna. I will do all these things. So really to please Krishna, we are. So this would be there, should be there. Not that I will be pure. Oh, you cannot be pure even your thousand and thousand baths.
Taking bath.
Yeah. Oh. But you can be purified in a high class of association very soon. So you should depend on this. And chanting and remembering. So Anya Bancha Anya Puja. Oh, what you are doing, worshipping? Anya Puja. Anya Puja means?
Trying to please others.
What to tell demigods says, like Indra, Varun, Jam, or others? Ganesh, Shankar. I have seen so many Ganesh, very beautiful golden Ganesh, in devotees' houses on the altar of Krishna. Why? Or he will give wealth and we will serve Krishna. For this, why you want all? Or this is annabancha. Try to give up all desires. I know that all cannot take this idea. Only those who are very fortunate, oh, they can have this idea. Puja.
Worship of Dwarkadish included in Anya Puja?
Eh?
Worship of Dwarkadish, is this included in Anya Puja?
Oh, Dwarkadish, Narayan even, but not of Nanda Baba. Narayan Puja. How? Oh, Narayan. Oh, give me some wealth. Something that I can serve Krishna. Oh, Giriraj Govardhan. Oh, you should give me so much things. To serve Krishna. Like this. So, for devotees, even they are worshipping any trina.
Nigras.
Even a blade of grass. Oh, it is helpful for Krishna Bhakti. They have no desire at all, only to serve Krishna, to please the devotees of Krishna. So you should try all to be like this. If you have self-interest, then bhakti will not come. Or he will send his duplicate. It's a very cheating mood. She will say, what he will say? Oh, karma mishra bhakti, jnana mishra bhakti, all other things. Oh, they will satisfy, this bhakti will satisfy. So much wealth coming, reputation coming, and you will be involved in that and bhakti will go forever. Try to realize all these things. Be very, very careful. Some devotees, oh, I am chanting, remembering, this is all. Why to go and bother? Why to accept any high class of guru? I am reading in books. I am hearing so many things, have heard. So I can worship Krishna myself. I can chant myself. No harm, I should. No need of offering myself in any lotus feet of any guru, because I have seen, he will think, oh, I have seen then so many gurus.
Falling
down. So I have not trusted in any guru. Then what will be? This is like offense. That in the world, whole world, there is no one devotee. Must be devotee. This world cannot be without
devotees.
If they go to hell, this world. So must be. So pray to Krishna that Rupa Goswami has told Adav Guru, and then initiation, then instructions, how to develop, and then our relation will come. Gradually, offenses will go. And thus, you can serve Gurudev like your
life and soul.
Like friends.
Pranabandhu.
Pranabandhu. Sadbandhu. Sadbandhu means?
Bosom friend.
Bosom friend.
Bosom friends. But in this world, any high class of devotee can serve like bosom friend to his Gurudev. Otherwise, he may do something wrong and offensive. Oh, to Guru, we will have to serve him as an appellant, having so much
a reverence.
Not neglecting. Gurudev gave any order, and if you are not following, he told that at least you should chant 16 times and daily in morning. You should remember all the months, what I have given, in what process. But they are not following. What is this?
Offense.
Like offense. It will increase your bhakti and you will give up.
Decrease.
So you should always be careful. If anyone not accepting Guru due to his fear that all are falling down, to whom I should believe? And he chanted. remembering. He has belief on Krishna. That, oh, he is not making offense, but something. So he should be also careful. He should pray to Krishna that please manage a guru like that, that Rupa Goswami has told. And it may be that he will not go to hell, but he will take his birth in any devotee house. And he will have chance to have a guru. And then he will have to come to in this process, whether he is following this process in one birth, lakhs birth, or lakhs of birth. But he will have to come one day in this process. So why not falling from now, beginning from now? Why losing all these times? Anukulle sarvendriya Krishna anushilan. By all senses, five jnanendriya and five karmendriya, you should engage all in Krishna anushilan always. Like he told, unbroken
stream of honey
from jar to earth, continuously. For this, if my whole appliances, wealth and everything is going, my wife is giving up, my children are giving up, whole world is becoming my enemy, no harm. Try to be like this. Then a valuable thing left, oh, this prema may come. Otherwise not. No process at all, any giving up this. A Shuddha Bhakti. So what you are doing, whatever you are doing, by any your senses, or try to do for the benefit of Krishna or his devotees. Don't do anything which will not help you. So you are going to do any work, any job, or first you should do that. By doing this, Krishna will be happy or not. My guru will be happy or not. All the associates of Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu will be happy or not. If Chhota Haridas went to
beg something.
No. To Madhavi Devi. He was old of
84 years
or 85. Oh, he should have first thought that why I am going? To please Mahaprabhu or not. And Mahaprabhu has first, before this, he has told that be careful for these things. And even he went. And he told that I am going to bring some rice. But matter was different. Mahaprabhu knew. And he punished. Always try to know the mood of Mahaprabhu, the mood of Gurudev. And then begin anything. এই শুদ্ধা ভক্তি ইহা হইতে প্রেমা হয় পঞ্চরাত্রে ভাগবতে এই লক্ষণ কয় ইট হ্যাজ বিন টোল্ড বাই বাট ইন পঞ্চরাত্র দের আর পঞ্চরাত্র রাত্র মিন্স জ্ঞান নলেজ পঞ্চ মিন্স ফাইভ অফ হোয়াট আর দে ইউ ক্যান টেক লাইক দিস কৃষ্ণ তত্ত্ব রাধা তত্ত্ব গুরু তত্ত্ব মায়া তত্ত্ব জীব তত্ত্ব অল দিস ইউ শুড নো দিস আর হোয়ার ইট ইজ রিটেন অল দিস থিংস দে আর পঞ্চরাত্র হাউ ইউ ক্যান অ্যাচিভ দিস কাইন্ডস অফ হাই ক্লাস অফ ফ্রেম অনলি রিডিং উইল নট ডু ও ইউ মাস্ট হিয়ার অ্যান্ড অনলি হিয়ার উইল নট ডু ইউ উইল হ্যাভ টু ফলো. If you are not following, always hearing here, like I told Lalit Mohan, bring me a glass of water. He was sitting there, as if he is sitting. I told that, bring me a glass of water. Still he is sitting. I told that, have you heard? Have you heard that what I told? I told that, bring a glass of water. Gurudev, why are you worried?
I am not there.
I have heard so many things.
I am not deaf.
I am not deaf, I heard. You are telling to hear, I am hearing.
Are you hearing?
Yes. Oh, this is not the symptom that you are hearing. What is the meaning of hearing?
Jump.
Oh Gurudev, what kind of water you want? He may ask. And what from where I should bring it? So what kind of water? Cold or what? Oh, water is so much. Oh, in this also raining water coming in the drain is. Or from where I should bring? He should know that. Or drinking water. And when I told him, then he brought very fresh water, good water, pure water, but it was too cold. It was so much too cold that I took and I became sick. Then what is this? So he should know the heart of Gurudev. The heart of Krishna, how we can please him. And thus, as a friendship, he should serve all Gurudev, Vaishnava, and all associates of Krishna. The sarva upadhi nirmuktam tatparatvena nirmalam rishikesha rishikesha rishikena rishikesha sevanam bhakti ruchyate. Sarva upadhi nirmuktam. Except Krishna Bhakti, everything is upadhi. All desires, all things are upadhi. So sarva upadhi nirmuktam. Now no false ego, no anger, no lust, no desire other than serving Krishna. And then Rishikena, Rishikesha, by all senses we should serve Rishikesh. Rishike means who is the mold root, and to be served by all senses. And then this is called bhakti. Also in Srimad Bhagavat, same thing has been told. But Rupa Goswami, this paribhasha,
definition
of bhakti is, oh, everything is enumerating, more superior than
anywhere else.
So Mahaprabhu became very happy to hear this. Afterward, it will be told. Bhukti mukti adi bancha. Jadi mane hai, sadhani karile prem na upajaya. If you have desired worldly sense gratifications, and even mukti liberation, and so many desires you have in your heart, and you are doing sadhana bhakti, oh, prem will not come. Never it will come. Oh, only your desires will be fulfilled. And then bhakti will, even that karma mishra bhakti, arap siddha bhakti will also go. But it may be that your desire will be fulfilled. Like whom? Like whom? Dhruva. And also like, I'm remembering one. Oh, that Bhasmasur. Bhasmasur, you know? Brikasur. He wanted to anyhow steal or wanted to take Parvati. And he did so much austerities to Shankar. And he told that, I want a boon. What you want? I want that a power should come in my, that to whom I will touch by my hand, or he should at once be finished, and only ashes should be there. Or Shankar told, oh yes, at once I am giving you. And then he came to see Shankar and told, I want to test this boon, whether it is right or wrong, and I want to touch you. And Shankar at once. Oh, very fast, very fast. So that his trigon fell. And his mrigachala, you know, Vyagrachala. What?
Loincloth.
Tiger skin here. Oh, it also went away. His damru, you know?
Drum.
Huh. Oh, it
left it.
He lost.
Right up.
And alone he was running, all naked, quite and very fast running. And then Krishna came as a boy. Oh, why Shankar, you are doing so? Oh, I'm fearing that this Bhasmasura will come and he will test and I will be finished. Oh, acha, you should go forward, I'm making something. And then he said like any
Brahmachari.
And Bhasmasura, Bhikasura was coming. Oh, that asked that boy, what man Krishna? Oh, have you seen Shankar going from, running away from here? I have seen, but what is the use? Why you are searching him? Oh, he gave a boon. I wanted to taste it. I be foolish.
Cool is the great.
Oh, you don't know that he is always drinking and with snake, poison, everywhere snakes.
Ashes.
And in ashes,
bone,
so much. He is like bad person, and you have believed.
You believe him.
You should not believe him. If you want to test, why not you used
yourself
to test? Oh, there is nothing. And by the maya of
Krishna.
Forget everything and very good. This boy is telling so. I should test. And as he kept
finished.
So if you are like that, then Krishna will send that is maya. Or Shankar also. And he will make you like that. Bhakti will go, you will be finished also. So if you are reading any Shastra, Srimad Bhagavatam, Gita, Chaitanya Charitamrita, we should try to follow fully. I know that you have not so much power, but you can pray your Gurudev to Krishna. If you are reading Gita, then Krishna. If Chaitanya Charitamrita, or Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Rup and all this, Krishna Dasa. If Srimad Bhagavatam, to Narad, Vyas and
Sukadeva
Goswami. And then you should read. You cannot do by reading. You should hear from, again and again, from any exalted Vaishnava. Otherwise you cannot do.
7 o'clock.
Then I have told about Shantaras, so many things. And then I have told about Shakhara and Dasharas, about Hanuman. Shantaras, about Sanat Sanandan, Sanat Kumar, even Sukadeva Goswami. And then I have told Shakharas about Siddham, Madhumangal and all. And I have also told you Vatsalaras of Yashoda. And also I have told Madhuras about Dwarka Mahishis, the queen of Mahishis, of Dwarka. And then my all the gopis, and especially of Radhika. I have told so many times. Here I have told or not. But you should know the difference between the kings of Mahishi, Mahishi of Dwarka and gopis, much different. They seem to be in Madhuras, but they are of only Dasharas, not more than that. Dasharas, not Sakharas. Not Madhur Rash. The Madhur Rash of Swakir in Golok or Dwarka is Dasharas, not more than that. But it is called half Madhur, but really not. It has been told, Mahaprabhu told, that once Rukmini was serving Krishna in his palace. He invited all the queens,
108. 108.
Oh, queens, how beautiful. Rukmini in his time, in her time, she was the most beautiful lady in whole world. Champion, world champion.
Miss Universe.
No? So all very beautiful person came there to marry. But she was only accepted Krishna. He called Krishna. Krishna came. So one day she was serving Krishna or giving. He took the chamar from maid servants. There were also like queen. And she was there. Oh, from on his hand, he gave a little net. And serving in his own hands. Satyabhama was also serving with his own hand. And in the meantime, Krishna became grave and told, Rukmini Devi, I am not fit for you. You are princess. And I am not...
No one knows.
No. I have no qualities. I am nirgun. And whether you have all kinds of... You are beautiful, in most beautiful in whole world. You have so many qualities. I am not wealthy. Only the person who are needy in this world and neglected by all. Poor and others. They can take shelter me and they call me. But you... All richest person in whole world, beautiful persons, they want you. So I think that, lo, tumra bole lo abhi. What you should tell, speak? What? Go on.
In English
you should.
Even Dwaraka, Bhagavan is asking that Braja Sakha is better than Dwaraka Mahishi. So if they are better, then why do Goswami describe in Madhura as a Sakya? Sakya and Parakya, the Rupa Goswami can explain that they are like Dasa. And when Satyabhama became man, then Krishna took him in Garuda and went to Narakasur.
So you should answer. What is the answer? Go on. Go on. Why?
No,
oh, this answer is also they all want.
We all want to know, please.
Go on.
And another question.
No question. I want her answer.
Question. The Rupa Goswami when described Sadharani Rati, Samanjasa Rati and Samartha Rati, why Rupa Goswami take the Mahishis or Queens of Dwaraka and Samanjasa Rati?
I don't know. First you should answer, then second. Go on. Don't waste time. I know that you are not speaking so much, so a chance should be given to you. Go on. Why shame? Yeah, bash. Okay. Bola. Bola toh. Tale amare ek vishram hai. Then, at once, Rukmini. Oh, he became senseless. Chamar?
Falling down
from his hand. And was rolling down on earth. And senseless, and he was like to die. Now Krishna became worried. And he told in his ear, very loudly, oh my dear, beloved Rukmini, I was not telling true, in true sense. I was joking. I remember when I was in Vrindavan. Oh, to gopis, even to Lalita, Vishakha, what to tell Radhika? If I used to joke with them, they used to joke more than me, myself. If I told that, anything, then they used to tell me what? Oh, you should be get out from our kunsh. We don't have any relation with this black person. Don't come in your life to us. We know that you are thief of women and very lumpet and so many things. Always chastising me. I thought that you are like so. And in worldly life, sometimes if there are two pots, they should thuk, thuk, thuk like this. So not in a shame. So I wanted to hear something that in anger how you speak, how your face becomes. I wanted to release all these things, like Gopi. So really, I have not told you. You are my beloved. And hearing this, a little sense came, and then he told them. Oh, really, what you have told, it is true. I am not fit for you. You are upasya of even Brahma, Shankar, Sukh, and all others. I am a daughter of any king, and you are himself Supreme Personality of Godhead. I have no quality, I have worldly qualities, and you transcendental all qualities. I know that I am not proper fit for you. Please excuse me. I want to be with you, being a maid servant in your
palace,
sweeping and doing all these services. I don't want anything. So even Rukmini, if he hears or anything, and they can become frightened, fear. And he begging his mercy of Krishna. Oh, you saw Arjun when he saw
in universal form.
And he became fearful. And he prayed that, Supreme Personality of Godhead, I have called you Sakha. I met
my charioteer.
I have told so many things to you. I have joked you. Oh, please be merciful. Forgive for this. From now, I am promising I will not tell all these things. So his Sakha bhav went down. And Rukmini's queen bhav and serving this mode went down. Yashoda saw two times universal form of Krishna. And he thinks that a ghost has come in the body of Krishna. And how to make it
go away.
And he went to his priest, Gargacharya, or Shandilya Rishi and others. Gargacharya is guru of Jadavas, not of Gopas, or Shandilya Rishi, and so many others. So he went and called them. And they came, very big problem, very big problem. At once you should donate
10,000 cows.
Lakhs of cows and bring some black cows. And they brought and the cow dung of that cow and urine mixing and making in his tail, in her tail, cows. And they, Lalate Keshavam Rakshita. Narayanam Atho Dade, and that's all they are doing. And they donated so many things. And now Krishna was happy and he was doing kilkari.
Laughing, smiling, laughing.
What, kilkari?
Like a small baby when he
laughs,
chuckling.
It is weeping and give use of them and doing like this. He may laugh at once.
Chuckling.
Even with tears. Whether tears are, but he can laugh. So Krishna began to do like this, laughing. And Yashoda was satisfied. My Lala is now shaped. Boys and all the gopis saw Krishna. He left at Govardhan for 7 days. It was so much affluence.
Aishwarya.
But even they thought that Krishna is not doing anything. Only by the worship of Nanda Baba, Narayan is doing from his all these things. And all the Sakhas were telling that, my Sakha is very weak. We should also help him. And so they took their sticks and
support.
And they were thinking that, Krishna has now no
power.
Any. We are doing. And what gopis? Radha and Lalita Vishakha. Oh, they were singing on Govardhan. Oh, if you are coming down, then what? You will be finished at once to ashes. So be on our vision. And thus, anyone never thought that Krishna is doing. So, they don't feel any affluence in Krishna there, in Braja. But in Dwarka, even for the kings, they are like servants, das only. And they can be feel affluence and they will pray to Krishna. Uddhav, he went to Braja, but he has so much affluence for Krishna, you see. So he always, if his friend ever anything but folding hands. He could not be any grass or blade of
Braj.
So this is so. So the mood of gopis is so high, so high. And we want no qualification. But hearing from the superiors, a greed has come that we will serve only Radhika and Krishna conjugal. Not anything else. No other desire. If coming, or taking out, then it will come. So this is the essence of Rupa Goswami Siksha from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But there are so many things. Who is Rupa Goswami? And then tell him. See, Rupa Swarupa, Priya Sarupe, Daita Sarupe, Prema Sarupe, Sahaja Abhirupe,
Prabhu Reka Rupe, Prabhu Reka Rupe, Tatana Rupe, Savilasa Rupe.
Dope, very. So, the meaning is very high. Gradually you should try to realize all these things. Rupa Goswami, by the mercy of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who wrote two verses. First was that the glorification of name.
Tunde Tandavini.
Tunde Tandavini. And second was what? Priya Sahachari. So young Priya Sahachari. The meaning and essence of that. Oh, so young Krishna. All these things. Oh, in the history of Vaishnava, they will be written in golden
letters
forever, eternally. So you should, if you want to engage your heart's mind in this, then you'll be a very rare high class of Vaishnava. I want to help you all. But you should also try to follow. If any desire you cannot follow, or something. So today, go Premanande.
I know that besides being the Murti of ecstatic love of Krishna, you're also the Murti of reconciliation. I was wondering if you could explain this. It's in the Sanatan Shiksha about the queens of Dwarka. It says, only in the conjugal mellow are there two ecstatic symptoms called rude, advanced, and adi-rude, highly advanced. The advanced ecstasy is found among the queens of Dwarka, and the highly advanced ecstasies are found amongst the gopis.
You can ask tomorrow. Oh, it is very
elaborate.
And I think that there are rare devotees to understand all these things. So we should also come from a beginning. We are all like beginners. But, so you should come near.
I've heard that you advise students not to read Srimad Bhagavatam, and I can understand that, you know, they should not go read some Sanskrit without purports, or to go reading some unknown translation without purport. So my understanding has always been that in the translation made by Sudha Brahma, the whole point of the Bhaktivedanta purports was to try to make it digestible for anywhere from very low devotee all the way up to very high devotee. So my understanding was the purports was specifically to make it digestible so that there wouldn't be that problem of
what?
Defect. He's telling that you are always saying that we should not read Srimad Bhagavatam.
I never told.
Then I was told wrongly by
Yes. I've never told like this. But rather I've told that of with honor you should read. And especially try to hear from bona fide Vaishnava. I've never. Oh, he may be another Narayan Maharaj. India, there are so many Narayan Maharaj. So anyone has wrongly told him.
But we encourage them to read.
You say best.
It may be Badri Narayan, not myself. Really. Badri Narayan. They have told you the advice of Badri Narayan, not this. Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Maharaj, the friend of Srila Bhakti Vedanta Maharaj.
Yes.
he wrote first Krishna book, and this is the purport and essence of Darshan. How I can say? My all Guru Parampara is telling to read with honor. I cannot tell. I cannot make offense like this.
What? He probably misunderstood that you always say the best thing is to first you should try to hear in the association of high class Vaishnava. He can explain everything to you. But if you're not in that association, then you should still, with honor, try to read, and if you're very sincere, then that will take you to a high class Vaishnava.
Certainly.
Just now you're saying that one should read with honor and pray to Narada Muni Srila Vyasadeva.
Yes.
You were saying just now.
Daily I'm telling all this. Go, Prabhu. Now you can prepare your
drama.